Okay, let's wake up. Okay, so we just kind of got this idea. We did something so small but so meaningful, which was introduce this idea of a variable. Now, you might feel a little bit sad with just this gray circle moving on the screen and there's not really a lot happening, and you want to have more splash pizzazz to your program. Let's look at something that will get us practicing with variables a bit more and allow us to kind of introduce a much more variety into our code, and that is the use of the random function. And I think this is really important for several reasons. Number one is that we now know that we have two kinds of lines of code that we can write. We have a function call, like line from a bunch of values to other values. And we also know we can have assignment operations where we take a variable and set it equal to something. We can even take a variable and set it equal to itself plus something. We can create all sorts of mathematical expressions that allow us to assign a value of a variable. But there's another way that we can actually do both of these. Crazily, we could do both of these in one line of code. And I'm going to show you what I mean by that. We can say something like x equals random 100. Now, look at this. This is both an assignment operation, assign x a value. I'm not in the video anymore. Assign x a value, and it's both a function call. This is a function. It has a name. It has arguments inside of parentheses. But what's so interesting about this is random is a different kind of function than line. And we can think of it this way. When I called the function line, I issued a command, a decree in a way, draw a line. When I call the function random, instead of issuing a decree, I'm actually asking a question. Oh, function random, could you please give me an answer to this question? What is a random number between 0 and 100? And the random function will say, aha, here is a random number between 0 and 100, 27. And it will give me that number back, and we're going to store it in the value x. This is incredibly useful. And in fact, there are lots of methods in processing. I think we're going to need to make a video just for this one that work this way. There's a function called map. There's a function called constrain. There are lots of functions that manipulate values for you and return back the answer to a question in a way, a random number between some minimum and some maximum. How is this useful to us? So let's look at just how. So first of all, let's just be a little bit more specific about how the random function works. The random function can take one argument. So that argument, let's say I put 100 in here, is the maximum random value. This will give us a random value between 0 and 100, the minimum and the maximum. It can also take two arguments, 50, 100, for example. This is the minimum, and this is the maximum. It will always give us a random number between 50 and 100. Now, the other thing that I should point out about this is it's not giving us 51, 52, 53, 54, 55. The random function actually gives you a floating point value back. So in fact, it almost is giving you an infinite number of possibilities. We're going to get values like 59.231789. We're going to get, 79.0035122. We're going to get floating point values. This is fine for us. If we've declared our variables as floats, we can get a float from random and everything's okay. There are some cases where you need to take the result of random and convert it to an integer. You'll see that in examples in the future, and we don't need to worry about that so much right now. So this is how the random function works. Let's go take a look at that in our program. We walk over here awkwardly. Okay, so for example, one thing we could just do really briefly, really quickly, is say, let's random 0, the width. So I actually want to give circle x a random value between 0 and the width of the window. And I'm going to do something else. I'm going to turn off the circle's motion by commenting out that line of code. This is often very useful. If you want to keep a line of code kind of in reserve, but you want to deactivate it, right, you can just comment it out. So it's commented, meaning the compiler will ignore it when it runs. So when we run this program, look, there's our circle. It's at a random location. Let's run it again. Whoa, it picked that. That was like the same location twice. What's the odds of that? Let's run it again and really hope we get something pretty different. Okay, I feel better now. There it is over there. We will get a new random value each time the program runs. Now, you might ask yourself, is it really random? Like, how random is it? You know, so the one thing we should just briefly mention is this random value comes from something known as a pseudo-random number generator. It's a mathematical function invented by people. Perhaps you could spend your life kind of developing pseudo-random number generators. You could write, you know, you could years of study, but we get one for free in processing. It is not perfect randomness in the sense that what you might find in some occurrence of nature, like, I don't know, if you heated up some gas and watched how the particles moved around in the gas, you might be able to, like, get some sort of more pure random out of that. But it will exhibit some kind of pattern over time. But we're writing, you know, sketches that draw little circles and colors on the screen. It's plenty good random for us right now. But it is coming. It's just a mathematical function written into processing that gives you a random sequence of numbers. And there's other controls we can impose over that random as well, which are more advanced that I would love to discuss with you sometime if you'd like to talk about that. Okay, so now that we have that, that's pretty good. But let's think of something a little bit more interesting. Let's have our circle start in the center of the window. So the circle should start at width divided by 2. Oh, ha! I got something for you. Remember how I was saying that everybody just wants to, like, give circle X's initial position up, initial value up here, because this is so much more convenient just to do it in one line of code. But I just want to give you a warning. This will not work for you now. This will fail because the width has not been established until size has been called. This is why you want to be careful about initializing all of your variables up here. Sure, it's more convenient and it's less code, less typing, and it's most of many examples you'll see do that, but this is a nice instance where, where circle X should be initialized here, and I feel very uncomfortable unless I know exactly where this pen is. Okay, so we've established circle X is going to be in the middle. We're going to move circle X again. Right? It's moving by 1, but what if I said this? Move circle X by a random value, and I need a little more space here, between negative 2 and 2, right? A random number between the minimum value is negative 2, the positive value is positive 2. Sorry, the minimum value is negative 2, the maximum value is positive 2. Instead of saying circle x equals circle x plus 1 every time through a draw, we're going to sometimes say circle x equals circle x plus 1.5, and sometimes negative 0.3, and sometimes 0.8, and sometimes negative 0.8. And if we run that, think about what it's going to do. If we run it, look what's happening. Let's zoom in on that. Whoops. Circle. What is it doing? It's moving randomly each frame at a different direction. So it gives us this jiggling-like quality. What if you had its size change randomly each frame? It's going to have this almost like, you know, we're programming like an incredibly nervous-looking circle on the screen. And it'd be nice, maybe we could think of some ways to calm it down and soothe it and, you know, be more gentle to it. But this is kind of interesting. Random allows us a lot of possibilities beyond just give it a random location where it starts. And this is giving us an inkling of that, of how you can start to create behaviors, personality in a way, to the shapes that you're drawing on the screen. So another thing that I just thought that I would briefly show you, I'm going to save this as random too. I guess what I might do is, all these examples are essentially in similar to other examples that I'm linking to, but I might, since I'm typing them out here and they're slightly different, I might put them somewhere else with the link you could download. I don't need to be telling you this right now, but okay. So let's just look at one other thing that I'll, so here's, that's an exercise that I might give you, which is use random to affect the X, the Y, the width, and height of a shape and see what type of personality you can give it. Here's another exercise to see if you can use random to essentially create a painting on the screen. And let's think, what are we going to do? Let's do a pointillist painting. So the first thing that I want to do here, and I'm going to get you started on this, is add circle Y. And the second thing I want to do is draw the circle at that location. And I'll give them both initial locations, and I'm going to take out this line of code completely, and I'm going to run this program. And what did we get? We get a circle that's in the middle of the screen. It's X and Y, width divided by 2, height divided by 2. There it is. Now, What if instead of assigning the initial value in setup, I give it a new value every time through draw? And I say, hey, give it a random value between 0 and with. My phone is ringing. Give it a random value. Always airplane mode before I make these videos. Give it a random, funny to answer it, but not that funny. Okay. A random value between 0 and width, and circle y, a random value between 0 and height. Now, we're doing that every time through draw. Instead of giving it a random value once and it sticks there, now we're giving it a random value every time through draw. Look, it puts it at a different location every time. But what if I took the background out and only draw the background once in setup? Now we're seeing the circle appear over and over again at different places. What if I gave those circles a little bit of alpha? What if I made the size of the circle random? What if I made random values for the color of each circle? Could I create some type of painting where all these random colors are blending? Could I constrain the randomness? Could I say the red is just between 50 and 100 and the green is between 150 and 175 to kind of create a palette of colors? So this, is, I think, is a nice exercise for you to kind of play around with. A, can you control the motion and of a singular shape through random? And also, could you create kind of this painting, this collection of stuff piling up with random as well, and create use alpha and color and size to really create some type of pattern, and you know, use lines, rectangles, other shapes besides circles. So that should get you kind of going with some stuff to play with in terms of using random. And that's what I got to say about that. Now I'm going to go and listen to that voicemail, and I'm banging the microphone, so I apologize if there was a popping sound or something.